With Shiori release, we got story quest for her. Without further ado, welcome to Nargashi Impact Story Quest. It's Shiori. Chisoria chapter, or Chisoria chapter. I don't know how to read that. Well, let's unlock it. And yeah, I'm so curious about what we're gonna see when they talk about tonight. Tonight? What are we doing tonight with her? What? Alright, without further ado, let's just go where Hornblade Clash, a fashion festival, is being held. A fashion festival? Interesting. Paimon gonna say something? No? Paimon's not gonna say anything? Is it actually nothing? It's actually nothing. Alright, without further ado, let's just head to location. I wonder what type of festival that's.
It seems like there's another event going on at the Court of Fontaine! Look at that! Roadside signs as far as the eye can see!
And I thought Paimon's not gonna.
Let's see what they're for. Hey. Fontaine Fashion Week?
Fashion Week.
Ooh, why don't we go check out some of the shops? Maybe we can pick up some cool new clothes.
Oh, I would love to see Lumin. Oh, I would love to see Lumin with new stuff. That would be cool. Let's see.
Is this really okay?
Oh! I love how everything that they show on Shiori's character trial is actually introduced on her story.
I told you I could do it using the leftover funds from the original deposit. Don't tell me you're afraid that I cheaped out on the dress.
No, not at all. I have only the fullest faith in your work, Miss Shiori.
Bang. If you say something bad will come to you.
I'm just in shock, that's all. It's always been my dream to wear a Chioria boutique dress for my wedding.
Ah.
I really thought the chance had passed me by.
Yeah, for guys that haven't watched the character trailer on Genshin Impact official YouTube, they actually show that she's creating a wedding dress for her. I don't know how to pronounce her name. Interesting.
Wait, so isn't that Chiori? She's actually at her shop today?
Yeah, for real! We never see her before. Also, another thing is, I noticed her vision also looked different. Did she redesign how it looked? Perhaps it's because of Fontaine Fashion Week, that's why she is here.
Oh, you've got a point there. Well, once she's done with her customer, we can go and ask her.
I'm a woman of my word. If I say I can do something, then it'll be done. The first rule of business is to always keep your promises.
Oh no, it's still Inazuma 1. Except the other part. Oh, I see. I thought it looked different. That is actually cool. It made like a petal looking this thing.
Now, remember to not fold the gown or store it under direct sunlight. I'd recommend only taking it out on the day of the wedding. But from the look on your face, I can tell that may be a little difficult for you.
I'm pretty sure that it's difficult for everybody. New outfit, obviously you wanna wear it, wanna look awesome, wanna see how it look and everything like that. And if it's also from Shiori's boutique or somewhere like famous, it will be, you know.
Oh, I'll try my best. Once he sees me in this, his jaw is gonna drop straight to the floor.
Are you sure he's not gonna charge at you immediately? Who knows, either way. that's gacha for you. I'll try my best not to pull for the character. Yeah, for guys that don't know how hard it is, it's pretty much like gacha. You gotta hold yourself.
Is that really so shocking? It is mine, after all.
It is actually shocking.
Anything you're looking for today? A custom design, or perhaps some ready-to-wear outfits for kids?
Is it Paimon? Or are you talking about my Serenity Pod? For people that don't know what is my Serenity Pod, you don't need to know. Also, is this covered because she threw a man out of a window? What? It's alright, Paimon. I don't think she is talking to you. We actually want to ask about Fontaine Fashion Week.
Oh. That. Well, if news of the event has reached your ears, I suppose the Fontaine Apparel Association's advertising efforts have paid off.
Oh.
Are there any fun and popular activities that we can take part in?
Yeah, is there any event that gives Primo jams?
Ugh, Fashion Week isn't what I'd call fun, but it certainly always attracts a crowd. It's a fashion extravaganza that only takes place once a year, after all.
Will you be showing off some of your designs, too?
Of course. All designers at the Court of Fontaine use the week to advertise their brand. If you're lucky, you could even land a large amount of orders as soon as the main show ends.
Oh, that's interesting. That's why a lot of people are there. Also, another thing is, I wonder if there's other people. The only people that we know that create outfit design is Shiori so far in the game. I wonder if there's others.
Come to think of it, it was also at a previous fashion week that our label first took off.
Oh.
Aren't you pretty much an established name now? People will still buy your clothes even if you don't participate this year, right?
No, it doesn't work like... Yeah, it literally doesn't work like that, Paimon.
Yeah, that's not quite how it works.
Yeah.
While many people buy clothes for fit and style, the fashion industry also strongly values a label's artistic vision and creative direction.
And a lot of people go with the crowd. Like, for example, if a lot of people buy this stuff and say it's good, obviously others will follow as well. So, this type of stuff is good for promotion.
Why would anyone patronize a label that hasn't even bothered to put out any new designs for the year?
Oh yeah, another thing as well, if you didn't show how good your outfit outside as well, it's not gonna be sold, so you have to actually show them first.
In the end, fashion is just a representation of the spirit of the times. People support your brand because they support the vision it represents.
Huh. Okay, so maybe fashion's more complicated than Paimon thought.
Rather than a fashion, I guess that's pretty much like most business stuff, I guess?
All that complicated stuff aside, you're saying we'll be able to see new Chioria designs at the show?
Absolutely. The designs have already been finalized. I'm just waiting for the fabrics to arrive.
Ooh, are you using materials you can't get in Fontaine?
Well, I still have a certain partiality to Inazuma-made fabrics. The textures are pleasant to the touch, and their familiarity gives me a sense of security.
No, it's just better than we.
Something like that. Yes.
Oh, no, it's actually something like that. Interesting.
We're a long way from Inazuma, though. Aren't you concerned that your shipment might get lost or stolen along the way?
No need to worry. I've already taken steps to ensure that it'll arrive safely. I've entrusted the job to Komani Express's most reliable courier.
Hirara, I see. She arrived.
Excuse me. Coming through! Coming through!
Kirara!
Chiori, your shipment's here. I know it's quite late, so I'm... Oh, really, really sorry.
Take a sit down, take a deep breath. What happened?
Deep breaths, Kirara. Then start again.
Oh, so Kirara's the courier you were talking about.
Kirara is the only courier that I know, actually. So that part is interesting.
Hey, Traveler and Paimon! Hello. Fancy seeing you here in Fontaine! It's been a while.
It is been a while. How about a game of Genius Invocation TCG? Shall I... hope they stop me?
Maybe next time. Considering how late this delivery is, I'm not sure this is the time to play cards. Plus, I know this shipment is really important to Chiori, so I should probably make sure everything's in order.
Even the game don't want to play a TCG. You know that say something about it.
Wait a second.
What?
This is the second time that you've seen me flub a delivery job now, isn't it? Oh, you somehow always happen to catch me off my game, huh?
Aww, don't feel that sad. You look cute though. What? Anyway, it does seem like she's not doing a proper job, but again, she do the entire, like, from Mondstadt to Fontaine, so, I mean... She is doing amazing, and she is alone.
So, what was the holdup? Sailing delays, bad weather?
Huh? No, nothing like that. I just ran into a bit of trouble, that's all.
Kirara, you probably forgot your tale kinda tell everything.
Bandits, then? Or treasure hoarders? A few run-ins on the road aren't usually enough to give you any trouble.
I'm pretty sure it's probably a cat problem.
Well, I didn't run into anyone exactly. I just got a little lost.
Your tails.
Keeping you honest as always, I see.
Yeah.
All right. I was stopped by a group of bandits as soon as I entered Fontaine. They were a little different from the ones I usually run into.
I could hear them mumbling about Comania Express. It was obvious they were looking for someone with two tails.
Ah.
So it was a targeted hit?
I got the sense that they were actually targeting Chiori's goods.
My fabric shipment?
Yeah, they said that I could go as long as I left the goods with them. Otherwise, they'd stuff me into my delivery box and toss me into the sea to drown.
I would love actually stuff Hirata to delivery box. What? But not toss into the sea to drown. I'm gonna toss it somewhere else that's comfy, like a bed. Never mind.
Oh, are you okay, Kirara?
Kirara is here. She's okay.
Oh, I'm good. I'm good. I'm still a yokai after all. I turned them over to the guards. It just took me a while to round them all up.
I actually thought she's gonna say something else. I know she's still yokai. I know she's strong, stuff like that. But I thought she's gonna say something. What was it? I forgot. I thought she's gonna say she stuffed those bandits and drowned them. Luckily, she didn't. The other thing is, are those bandits? I'm guessing that bandits is from that NPC from the trailer. Wait, is this the first time they show a character story based off trailer? Or trailer character story, something like that?
Well, it's not completely out of the ordinary for one of your deliveries to get intercepted. But it still doesn't make sense how you knew it was my goods they were after. You've got other deliveries to make in Fontaine, don't you?
That's actually a good point. Well, I mean, she's a yokai.
Is there something else that you're keeping from me?
Chiori is also pretty sharp.
Huh? Well...
We don't need to see or tell, but...
Perhaps I need to reconsider how many stars to give you in my review.
Dang!
You always know how to get me, Chiori. Alright, I'll talk.
She's also sad. I kind of feel bad, but she also sounds cute, so...
So, I kind of wanted to know why anyone would order a hit on me, so I spent a bit of time investigating.
Ah.
One of the bandits had a loose tongue, which saved me some time. He said that a certain person had commissioned them to intercept Chioria Boutique's delivery.
I'm guessing that person got a, what, important dinner night, so he need outfit. But again, Chiori's first come, first serve. And yeah. So Chiori is focusing on the wedding dress instead.
And who might this person be?
Chiori, why don't we just let this one go? I mean, I didn't really get injured and you've still got Fashion Week to worry about.
I love how Kirara is worrying about those people instead.
I appreciate your kindness, Kirara. But if I don't teach this person a lesson, I doubt they'll stop here.
Yeah, I love Kirara just like, yeah, let's not, you know, the last time you throw them out of the window, right? So how about...
Anyone that dares to mess with one of my friends deserves a stern talking to and then some.
Oh, it's because you mess with Kirara, not because targeting on the, whatchamacallit, the shipment? Dang. I want to be her friend.
Alright. The guy said that the commissioner was someone by the name of Uter.
Uter? Now that name rings a bell. Wouldn't you say, Kirara?
Well, that's exactly why I didn't want to bring it up to you.
So you both know this Uter guy?
Who is this guy?
Through Chiori's complaints about him, sure. He's a fellow fashion designer who's made it his goal in life to make hers as miserable as possible.
Ah, that type of person. Why do this type of person always exist? I don't get it.
Oh, so he's like a business rival.
Do you have to say it like that, Paimon?
A rival is what you call someone who fights you fair and square.
Ooh, so what do you call this guy then?
Uter, however, just has it out for me as a designer. He's publicly disparaged my design choices, my use of materials. He's practically tried every trick in the book to ruin my good name. I've already warned him before to compete with me fair and square, but I guess he prefers playing dirty. Well, I'm more than happy to oblige.
I'm scared. I'm more scared now. Where is
Wait,
she going?
Wait, Chiori, where are you going?
Yeah, where is she going?
To teach someone a lesson.
Ah.
You must be tired after your long journey. Why don't you rest in my shop for a little while before heading back?
So, Kirara, what happened when she's mad?
Chiori! Wait!
And she's she's gone.
Oh no. What should we do?
Take a rest, because there's nothing we can do.
You seem concerned. Should we be worried about Chiori?
No, I'm pretty... Story always goes like this. You don't worry about that person. You're worrying about the person that they are gonna face. You are worrying about them instead.
Well, she's always been the type of person to face things head on. But with her fiery temper, I'm just worried whatever she's about to do will fuel negative publicity about her right before the start of Fashion Week.
Oh, I see. Oh, that might be the other guy is, what, target as well. Oh, Kirara is... That is good thinking there. I didn't even think about that.
Traveler, Paimon, could you go after her and check out the situation for me? As a formal employee of Komania Express, it wouldn't be appropriate for me to get involved.
Also, another thing is you got delivery to deliver. So sure, I gotcha.
Yeah, we'll take good care of Chiori.
To be honest, I'm more worried about that Uter guy's safety.
Yeah, I know. We know. With that, when they talk about tonight, they mean tonight. Anyway, she's still here. She's not. Oh, she's still here.
Anyway, please look after Chiori for me.
I gotcha. I already looked after you before, so it's now Chiori time. When Chiori catch up with Chiori?
Yeah.
Interesting. I know there's more actually to this. But I thought it was from the trial, but the trial one is only... Oh. Okay. It's whether Chevro is trying to stop her, or she is telling Chevro. Let's see. I thought the story is gonna be like the trial one, but it's not.
Any chance you're on the clock, officer?
Oh, gotcha. Alright, that's good. So Chiori is telling Chevro.
Nothing good ever comes out of you addressing me like that.
What happened?
Oh? And I see the Traveler and Paimon are here too.
Hi!
Chevrez, we meet again!
Are you out on a patrol? Has everything been going well?
Well, things have been fine on my end. We were able to bring in a large number of recruits thanks to that film we made.
Oh. Right! Oh, it's still got something to do with those. The film... Oh, that's an event, isn't it?
I suppose the trade-off is that I'm now constantly getting stopped for autographs while out on patrol. Not ideal, if you ask me.
Hey, you're more famous than me now, that's good. Also, another thing is, isn't the filmmaking is a van, right? Is it? So, yeah, people that don't do it, then not gonna get what does that mean?
Well, you were one of the leading roles after all.
So, did something happen?
Well.
Indeed it did. I'll need you to come with me. I only ever hear that phrase from you. Usually, I'm the one asking people to do that. Well, are you coming?
She's like, can you come already, Jesus?
Not before I know what you're planning.
I wonder what happened in the past.
Have I ever made a bad call?
No, she... Surprisingly, never.
The better question is, have you ever made one that didn't violate proper procedure?
Ah.
Okay. A man hired a group of bandits to mug my friend. I'm about to go teach him a lesson.
Are you sure this is something you should be telling the captain of the special patrol? It's getting hard to tell whether you're here to report a case or turn yourself in for one.
Friend, right? Again, Chiori is a type of person that care, but... Face head on, cruel mouth, but a good one.
Neither. I'm requesting personal supervision from said captain, so I don't do anything too out of line.
Are you planning to?
Not if I can help it.
This is interesting. I like how honest she is.
Alright, where is this person?
Follow me.
Chevro, is this every day? I always thought. Dang! Hello! I love how it turned out to be like this.
Just promise you'll start trying to keep yourself out of trouble.
I'm gonna not follow.
Well, when trouble stops coming my way, I'll be sure to get on that.
Interesting. Again, I'm not gonna follow the character where they're running to, cause it gonna... The character should leave me. It gonna actually cut the dialogue sometimes, so yeah. I love how she just runs straight. Leave me behind. This is the house.
You all wait here. I'll go have a chat with him.
What does chat mean?
You know, Chevrez, Paimon gets the sense that you two are actually pretty close.
Same.
It's just as Chiori said. We got to know each other pretty well in our lines of work. You could call it a you scratch my back and I'll scratch yours sort of situation.
Yeah, that feels nice.
Does Chiori often need your help?
I'd say it's mutual. The Special Patrol needs her help quite often as well. We've got tough problems of our own. Getting people to talk, for example. The uniform, the musket, they're intimidating. Most people clam up the minute they see us. Lips sealed so tight, getting them to talk almost feels like trying to break into the Fortress of Meripede.
Yeah, that's why you need a casual person.
But put them in a clothing boutique, and they suddenly start gushing faster than the waters at the Fountain of Lucene.
Oh, is it because they're trying to show off or something?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yep. People are vain creatures.
Dang,
they can't help but want to talk up new developments in their lives or show off how much they know about other people. And nothing brings out that sort of vanity quite like fashion. As a result, Chiori often picks up on all kinds of information in her shop. Most of her customers are members of the upper class, which means they're pretty much up to the gills in wealth and intel.
Yeah, and also another thing, when they're, you know, too high, they kind of too troublesome.
You scratch my back and I'll scratch yours. Huh, Paimon gets it now.
So Paimon, will you scratch my back? What?
Exactly. I'm also here to ensure Chiori's safety. Those who make trouble for her also tend to be rich and powerful.
Ah.
And in some very rare cases, I'm forced to protect other people from Chiori herself. So, who got on her case this time? It's been a while since I last saw her that angry.
Well, if somebody have troubled you for the longest time, and then now they attack your friend, I'm guessing I'll be that mad as well.
Oh, so this is what happened.
We actually tell the entire story. Gotcha. I like that sound effect and skipping.
Uther, you say?
Oh, you know?
You've heard of him?
Uh-oh.
Yep. He's made trouble for Chiori several times already. He's fond of pretty much every dirty trick in the book. I heard that even the Maison Gardiennage issued him a warning due to his behavior.
Why couldn't you just catch him?
So he's back at it, huh? His funeral, I guess.
I don't know if I should take that as a, you know, literally funeral or not. Time to call Hu Tao?
Whoa, what's this about a funeral all of a sudden?
Wang Xun time Paimon, let's go to Wang Xun funeral parlor.
I just meant that Uther's done for. Now bring it in, you two. Get right up close.
Sure, but... why?
Because this is probably going to turn into one of those very rare cases I just talked about.
Gotcha. Oh! That... what you meant? Okay. I know she have kicked somebody out of a window, or throw somebody out of a window, but I didn't know she's just gonna... maybe this other guy need to lock their doors.
What are you doing? Stay away from me!
Ooh, Pip.
Has anyone ever taught you the definition of stupidity?
Huh?
Huh? What?
Stupidity is doing the same meaningless thing over and over again.
Dang.
It appears you've forgotten what I told you before. So, allow me to refresh your memory. Lay off the dirty tricks.
Dang, whenever I see Shiori is not cool. Or her hot hat.
Oh, and if you dare lay your hands on my friend again, you can expect a far less pleasant landing next time.
That is not pleasant.
Chiori?
I mean, that's pleasant. Dang.
Officer, an assault's in progress. Please, officer, you've got to do something!
Well...
of course. I'll do my utmost to investigate the situation. Unfortunately, I was chatting with this traveler and seemed to have missed what happened. Not to worry, though. If you'd allow me to search the scene, I'm sure I'll be able to collect some useful evidence. You don't mind, do you? There's nothing in there that would implicate you in any illegal activity, I would hope.
I... Gah, forget it. It wasn't that big of a deal.
Ms. Chiori, I must also ask you to refrain from engaging in such disorderly conduct in the future, especially out in the open like this.
Apologies, officer. I guess you could say I'm just used to tossing out any trash I come across on the street.
Oh, you just got called trash?
You...
Is there anything else either of you have to say for yourselves?
That's all from me. I sincerely hope that today's events will never happen again.
We'll see about that.
Oh, it's gonna happen again. That person never learned their lesson. So thank you, Chevron, for telling us to step aside, because that man almost landed on us. Such an incredible strength. Has a graceful arc.
You're too kind.
You're welcome.
Now's not the time to be accepting compliments. What happened to not doing anything too out of line?
Anyway.
Oh, not if I could help it, is what I said. And I think I kept to that.
Yeah, she does, actually.
I started with a verbal warning, but he displayed neither shame nor remorse. If anything, he kept running his mouth with insults and threats.
And we can hear that when he is literally outside.
Insults and threats so bad that he deserved to be tossed out like a sack of trash?
Yes.
Believe it or not, they were that bad. He deserved to get knocked down a peg. It's the only way to get him to stop.
You could have reported him to the guards.
I mean, she reported to you, no?
Oh, I will. But it'll take some time for them to gather evidence. And he denied that he ever had anything to do with those bandits. I don't want anything else to happen during Fontaine Fashion Week. On top of that, if Kirara is going to continue delivering goods for me, the least I can do is guarantee her safety. Oh, that reminds me. There is another favor I'd like to ask of you today.
What a shame. I believe you've already used up your favor quota for the day.
Have I? Well, it's a good thing I was planning on taking an advance on tomorrow's quota, then.
Don't you think you're maxed out on advances already?
I always pay you back in information, don't I?
What is this friendship?
It's just like you said. You scratch my back, and I scratch yours.
Okay. I'm curious what, but okay. Can we hear? No, we can't hear. Dang, I also want to throw that person, actually. That person hurt Kirara. How will I let that person go? Alright, let's go there now. We are here on Chiori Boutique. What happened?
We're
okay, Rai is still here. We're back where Chevron. Chevron.
You were gone for an awfully long time. Oh, please tell me nothing bad happened.
Other than somebody kissed a floor, nothing bad happened.
There's nothing to worry about. All you need to know is that you'll never have to worry about someone in Fontaine messing with your deliveries again.
I don't think it worked like that, but we'll see, I guess.
Sorry, Chiori. I didn't mean to cause you so much trouble.
Chiori, have pet her.
What are you talking about? You didn't do anything wrong. Those greedy bandits are to blame, along with a certain someone who doesn't know when to lay off the petty tricks. The next time you need to leave the city, call the Special Security and Surveillance Patrol. They'll escort you half of the way, and the Spina di Rasula can take the second half.
I see, so that's the other favor. Chiori asked for a private guard favor, gotcha. Also, I like how I didn't even see Navia. Apparently Navia as well. So again, inside Fontaine, it's gonna be the guard, and outside Fontaine, aka like outside the city or our area here, will be Spina.
With that sort of escort, ooh. The next time you make a delivery, those treasure hoarders won't go anywhere near your goods. Unless, of course, it's to offer to carry them for you.
good one, Chiori.
Come on, Kirara.
I'm being serious. You know me. If I bring something up, you can assume it's already a done deal. You're going back to Inazuma tomorrow, right?
Wait, you don't mean...
I've already spoken to the captain of the Special Patrol. As discussed, the patrol's going to take a small detour during their daily training tomorrow. As for Navia,
I'll give her a heads up in a bit.
Oh, gotcha. I thought she already talked to Navi, and I'm like, when? How? What?
There's really no need. I'm just a simple courier. I don't need to be surrounded by a bunch of armed guards. Or ones with sunglasses, for that matter. Don't you think this is a bit much?
Whoa, don't talk about Navi like that. Come on.
Well, you certainly shouldn't count on such a procession for every trip you make to Fontaine. It's just a one-off thing. For my own peace of mind. It'll also show those guys what'll happen to those who dare to mess with my friends.
Ooh, I like Shiori a lot now. Since she's already talked to the patrol and there's no taking back. Just think of it as, you know, you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours type of situation.
Yes, well put.
We're just using her word now.
Well, if you think it's a good idea, Traveler, then I guess it's fine.
I don't know if you got cornered because Tufi won, or you actually fun of us.
Well, with the bad guys out of the way and your goods safely delivered, everything should be good to go for Fontaine Fashion Week, right?
Nope, not quite.
I believe so. I'll try to churn out a few more outfits over the next few days. I've heard a lot of suppliers will be participating this year.
Pylon's gonna take a guess and say if suppliers are super important.
But of course. They supply us designers with funding, equipment, factory access. You have to work with them if you want to become a truly renowned fashion house.
Damn, that's a lot.
That's also why this year's Fashion Week is so important to me.
But isn't your brand already really famous, Chiori? Your clothes are so pretty and so nice to wear. I can't help but brag about them to my customers whenever I get the chance.
Even so, I would imagine there are still people who've never heard of the Chioria brand, yes?
Yeah, however famous you are, however many people, you know, there are, there's no way everybody gonna know you. There will always be a person that didn't know you.
Well, I mean, with the amount of places that I deliver to, it's only natural that some people from other nations haven't heard of it.
Because, yeah, somebody like me, for example, people that know a lot of famous people and then start asking me, I have no idea. If you start coming here and ask who is this or you know this, I'm just gonna be like, who?
Then it's still not famous enough. My goal is to make the Chioria brand renowned throughout all of Teyvat.
I like her pose. It's pretty much saying, I love this entire earth, know my brand.
All of it? Your business would have to get pretty huge then.
Wait, would that mean I could just go to any Chioria branch on the continent to get my clothes fixed? It has been pretty inconvenient having to come to Fontaine every time I need to get them patched up.
Oh.
Alternatively, of course, you could just be a bit more careful with them. They're already about as durable as I can make them.
Okay, I'll admit, they do get snagged on branches pretty often. But I can't help it. It's hard to be careful about that sort of thing when you're trying to take a nice nap in a tree.
Yeah, I'm about to say, a cat loves to sleep on top of a tree, so I'm guessing that's what she do.
Well, if that's your dream, Chiori, then we should do our best to make it a reality. Is there anything we can do to help out with Fashion Week?
I'm sure I could think of something.
Ooh, what is it? What is it?
Ooh, what is that, noises?
Why don't you come to my shop tomorrow and model for me? Simply put, you'll serve as my living mannequins.
Oh, we're actually gonna see Lumin wear other outfit? Oh, I'm looking forward for this.
Oh, so we get to try on some of your clothes? Got it!
Seeing them off the rack will also give me the chance to make some small adjustments to the stitching and the silhouette of the designs.
Sounds easy enough.
Alright, do you need us, for the runway too? Or can we keep the outfit?
Most of the clothes you see during Fashion Week are meant to showcase the designer's vision. They're not exactly suitable for ready-to-wear use.
Ah, I see.
If you like them, though, feel free to visit the boutique and see if anything catches your eye. I'll even give you a special discount.
Not even free? What the heck? Also, I really hope... Yeah, there's a shop where you can buy outfit for a character. I'll love that. This talk is just like... Just a talk, gosh darn.
About all this design stuff.
Or also, if anything, yeah, in the future, maybe they're gonna add outfit for Traveler, but if anything, if you got an outfit from this story event, It will probably only be inside your inventory.
Then we have a deal. You'll muddle some formal wear, Traveler. And, I don't know, Paimon here will show off some kids' designs. I'll see you both tomorrow then.
Paimon don't need to take it too hard.
Yep, sounds good. Wait, kids' clothes? Paimon told you already, she's not a little kid!
I told you don't take it too hard. So sorry, Paimon, but there's nothing we can do about this type of stuff, not gonna lie. Alright, let me talk to them.
Speaking of clothes, do yours happen to need any mending right now, Kirara?
Mending?
Well, since you asked, Chiori, there's this part around my waist.
Again?
Oh, need a bit of letting out around the middle.
No! It's a tear! Those bad guys did it!
I don't get what? What does those mean? I don't know what does those mean. Oh, you mean she body slowly going big. I love how I AFK here for a bit because I'm doing something. And then they're talking about Fashion Week is around the corner.
Fashion Week is coming up.
There you go.
Oh, my husband promised to get me a replica of the most eye-catching outfit from the show.
Eye-catching outfit? That's a thing?
Fashion Week is coming up. Oh, my...
Oh, I say. As expected of a high-flying merchant. How generous of him. Well, what a coincidence, though. My husband promised me precisely the same thing.
Man, I feel bad for you guys as husband.
Whatever are we going to do then if we fall in love with the same dress?
Not a person?
Well, let's leave our gentlemen to figure that one out for themselves, shall we?
Fashion Week is coming up.
And this is why single is better. I wonder if I should actually try to talk to everybody that's here. You look different. Is that look good enough picking a gift? Wait, you look entirely different. Sailing to other nations. Sailing to other nations. Ah. Wait, this got nothing to do with anything. Help. Skip. Skip. There's also no voice act. Oh my god, it's a lot of chat. Gonna be a secret quest. Who knows? Skipping time. Wait till next morning. Okay, next morning it is. Alright, here we are on the day that we're supposed to be the day on. Go to Chiria Boutique. I'm already here. Oh, you can go inside now. Nice. Let's see, I'm looking for again Lumin's outfit. Because main character never used like other outfit, I couldn't help but to be excited now.
Chiori, we're here!
Oh dang, the inside is so pretty. Oh, I like the Inazuma hat as well on the top left.
I haven't even opened the shop yet.
Early? I was 1 hour late.
Wait, has Kirara left already?
Probably not. Yeah, I like this again, this from Inazuma. Oh, it's a cat!
Yep, with the special design. Bright and early.
Did everything go all right on the road?
I believe so. The patrol makes for quite the entourage.
I thought she was gonna say I don't know because I didn't follow them.
The way they marched forward with Kirara in the center, you'd think she was some sort of VIP. For the second leg, the Spina also came with a pretty large group, led by Navia herself.
I... This is cute! I love Navia! Kira is just like, nope, I'm gonna hide inside this box. Nope, I wonder if she always run like this, or do she actually use human form? Whichever though, I like Navia. I love Navia.
They took care to clear the path beforehand as well. Kirara won't so much as step on a single stray rock on her journey. I even heard that Navia decided out of the blue to make a batch of macarons as a going away gift for Kirara. An excellent souvenir to remember Fontaine by, I'd say.
Also, yeah, she is so nice. She still look a little bit, how do I put it? Adorable, we'll just put it adorable. But yeah, Navia always love to make macarons for friends, so that's good.
Sounds like Navia really got into it.
You don't say. From that picture, you don't say. I guess those pictures are imagination about what happened.
My thoughts exactly. She even lamented the fact that she didn't have time to prepare something even fancier. I'm pretty sure she can't wait for another escort opportunity to come her way.
For sure. If it's friend, she's gonna do more.
You know, now that you mention Navia, Paimon thinks the two of you are actually pretty similar. You say what you mean, and when you have an idea, you really hit the ground running.
Except one is friendly and the other one is less friendly. It's just, you know, too cruel with mouth, and one is, you know, nice. You get it.
I suppose that's why we're such good friends.
I see. Not because of Gio?
Navia has a certain resilience about her. It's part of who she is. No matter what comes her way, she never bows down in the face of adversity. That sort of determination and courage is something I really admire.
Dang.
That same spirit is the true vision of my brand. When she first mentioned commissioning an outfit from my boutique, well, I'm sure you can imagine my excitement.
Yeah, if you adore somebody and also you look up to them and they ask help, you are gonna be so hyped. I know that feeling.
It's like finding the perfect brand ambassador, huh?
Indeed. Customers pay attention not just to the clothes, but also to the figures in society who wear said clothes. People like to copy the styles of those they look up to.
Yeah, also another thing is, Navia is well known in Fontaine, or the Spina, and people know Spina is awesome.
Huh, and here Paimon thought all that mattered was for the clothes to look cute.
Like I said, Paimon, there's more to this.
Fashion is about more than just looks, my dear. Especially if you've got your sights set on a market the size of Teyvat.
Man, Paimon, you're lucky to get called deer. Wait. At least you didn't get called moose, I guess.
Well, would you look at the time?
Oh yeah! Come on, let's get down to business! We're here to model!
Indeed. Give me a moment while I go retrieve some fabrics and sample outfits. Why don't you help me set up the shop displays in the meantime?
Okay.
Set them up? How exactly?
I'll just pretend I know what to do, not gonna lie, Paimon, but now that you ask.
Just carefully organize the ready-to-wear clothes with an eye toward their types and styles. This way, we can guarantee that the customers will see something different every day.
Whoa, there sure is a lot that goes into running a store.
Well then, I'll leave the displays to you.
So where's your other fellas? I thought the other fellas were supposed to be here as well.
We just need to put all the clothes with similar styles together, right?
Pretty much, I suppose. There are three of them here, so you know.
Please organize the clothes with an eye towards their types and styles. I'm counting on you.
Hey, towards their eyes, types, something. 1 + 1 = 2. What does that mean? Oh, I see. Formal. Oh, gotcha. Formal attire. Kimono. There you go. Kimono. This one is formal attire for men. Women. Like that. An eye of that style, right? That seems easy. I wanna put it different, but I wonder what she's saying.
Not bad. You might just have an eye for design.
Now I'm curious. What happened if you put it wrong? Is she gonna say something cruel?
Anyway, let's move on to the real task at hand. Over here, stand still. I'll take your measurements first.
Oh, I'm so hype. Oh, somebody?
Excuse me, Miss Chiori.
Oh, good morning, Leanne. How have you been recently?
Not too bad.
Okay, what is happening?
Your gown will be ready next week, so there's no need to worry about missing the ball. Or did you come here today because you'd like to make a new request, perhaps?
She is going to the ball?
Oh, no. Nothing like that, Miss Chiori. To be honest, I came here today to cancel my order for that gown.
Now, why? I got a feeling that person is the cause.
Cancel your order?
But you can keep the deposit, of course. I know you can't return any materials you've already used.
Don't worry about the materials. I'm more concerned about you. Did something happen, Leanne? Have your plans changed?
Jose, why did you cancel? If you give the money regardless, right? Just grab the outfit, it's fine. I mean, yeah, it's fine. In the future is gonna be used, even though you don't miss, or if you miss the ball, or you don't want to go to the ball. But that's not the case. We know something happened.
It's alright. I'm not trying to make things difficult for you. I'll take note of the cancellation.
Thank you. I'm really sorry.
Don't worry about it. Just let me know if there's anything I can do to help.
Yep, that's for sure. Okay, I don't know what is happening, but okay.
Is it just Paimon, or was she acting a bit strange just now?
wonder why she wouldn't tell us why she was canceling her order.
It's not a big deal. These things happen every once in a while. A family emergency, an important payday falling through, a lover's quarrel, no one to take you to the ball. I've pretty much heard it all.
I got a feeling that's more than that.
Judging from the look on her face, something's keeping her from revealing the truth to us. It's best not to pry.
Well, guess this means you'll have more time to work on Fashion Week, right?
That's true. Come, let's pick up where we left off.
Right, the Alpha Africa. That is... okay, another one.
Is Miss Chiori in?
Are you cancelling as well? If you're cancelling, then something's up.
I am. How can I help you?
I'd like to return this item.
Oh, could I ask why?
It's just, not to my liking. You said I could get a refund if I wasn't satisfied, so that's why I'm here.
Is there something about it that didn't meet your expectations? Are the sleeves too short, or is the color too dark? I can always make those adjustments for you.
You can adjust color? Oh, I guess you can, yeah.
No need. You don't have to concern yourself with that. I'd just like that refund, please.
As soon as people sounds like that, I know something's up.
And I'd be happy to process that for you. If you could just tell me the cause of your dissatisfaction.
Is Chiori here? I'd like to return my outfit.
What the heck is going on?
Another one?
Is there some sort of new calamity coming that I haven't heard about? Another flood? Or an apocalypse, maybe? What does the prophecy say this time? You'll be spared if you get rid of all your clothes? Surely the entire population of Fontaine didn't convene and pick this one day to come and return my clothes. What is going on?
Yeah, you gotta come out and tell the truth, buddy.
What kind of rags are you trying to sell us, huh? The way I see it, this shop is nothing more than a black market front run by a bunch of dirty criminals.
What?
Please calm down, sir.
What is he talking about?
Haven't you heard? Chioria Boutique has been exposed for having close ties with criminals. It's all over the papers.
What?
And just who is it that dares to throw that accusation around?
Well, she is mad. Yeah, I'm about to say, why do you just believe like that?
Well, you tell us. The fabrics you've got here, they're all sourced from underground factories, aren't they?
No, that's literally Kirara deliveries. What?
I've been transparent about my materials from the very beginning. I've already proved there's nothing wrong with them.
So who is making this? We need Charlotte's help here.
If a little hearsay and baseless slander are enough to convince you, then by all means, go ahead and hand over your garments right now. Spare yourself from that flood of yours. Or have you not been convinced of that one just yet?
I kinda hate when people start just believing everything. So I'm actually pretty mad as well right now.
You...
It's not you, you are the problem, buddy.
Eloth! Miss Chiori?
Dang, she screamed. She is mad.
Go outside and help these customers with their return requests. There's no need to ask them why. We'll refund them at the purchase price.
Alright.
Dang, Chiori is so nice.
And once you're done, put up the sign that says we're closed for the day.
Got it.
Guessing Chiori already know what is going on.
Chiori...
These rumors. Obviously we know it's fake.
They couldn't be more fabricated if you tried. No need to worry about them. I'm sure they'll go away on their own in a few days.
But I guess we already know who is, you know, behind all of this.
The real goal here is to divert my attention away from Fashion Week. The best response right now is to tune it out and focus on finalizing my designs.
Yeah, that is a smart choice there.
If you say so, but... Paimon still can't help but worry.
The best way to respond to public skepticism is to let your work speak for itself.
Yeah.
There will be no doubt about the quality of my work once my new designs are released. The public just has to see it for themselves.
Yeah, public always do this type of stuff, like just believing on anything. Couldn't they at least see a proof first? Not a puny proof, of course. It's like, you got shown proof. At least like read everything. If it's properly, then good. If it's, you know, something is missing, then ask question, not just like, oh, so this and this. There's no way that's Photoshop, right? It's like, bruh.
Miss Chiori, bad news.
What happened?
Oh, for the love of... Can a woman not get a moment of peace to do her work? Go on. What's the matter now?
It's our accessories supplier. They just sent word that they'll no longer be able to supply us during Fashion Week.
What? No accessories? Not even the ones we pre-ordered?
Oh, sadly we don't know anybody with a good accessory stuff.
Yes, that's what their messenger said.
And what about the models we asked them to book for us?
I think they'll probably pull out as well.
Even the suppliers believe those nasty rumors?
Is the messenger still here?
No, they've already left.
So, no accessories means no brooches, no bow ties, things like that?
Oh, I mean, I also got some gems and stuff, you know, inside my inventory, so we can do something about that. I forgot, wait, is there somebody that designed that for us? I forgot.
Not just that. It means no gems, ribbons, gold thread, all the elements that lend life and soul to my designs.
Yeah, we are. I'm gonna call the adapters. I'll be right back. Going and find Xianyu.
But if you take those away, does that mean you won't be able to make your designs at all?
Aloth, you stay and watch the shop. I'll go talk to the supplier myself.
We'll go with you. Maybe we'll be able to find out what is happening.
Yeah, and we can vouch for you too. We'll make sure your supplier knows there's nothing wrong with your clothes.
And people know me as a traveler. I'm pretty famous, so that will do stuff.
Thank you. In that case, please come with me.
Alright, I'll come with you. Man, so that's how they cut it out for Lumin outfit character design. Oh, I was looking forward for that. Oh, so this is cool. I guess you sit here while people are designing your clothes. Awesome.
I know Miss Tiori has put a lot of work into making Fashion Week a success.
We for sure know. She's so mad as well.
I hope you can talk things through with the supplier.
We will. Obviously we will, but... Yeah, again, the problem... Yeah, that guy, the troublemaker, we already heard that he is rich and stuff like that, so... We kinda know. I just don't get why people hate others because they are doing good. It's like, you don't try hard enough. Unless the other person is doing something bad, which, again, Shuri don't do anything bad, then you can hate him, but again, Shuri don't do anything bad, so you know. Today?
Did you read the paper today?
Oh, I did. My goodness, I couldn't believe what I was reading.
You should not even believe it.
Do you think there's any truth to it? Have you asked your husband? He's a judge, isn't he?
You would never indulge in such idle gossip. Still, he advised me to hold off on buying any more related wares for the time being.
Well...
Yes, how prudent. Wait for the dust to settle. My husband said the same.
I mean, it's the safest thing to do, so... Yeah.
Indeed, indeed. I wouldn't want to invite scandal through one of my purchases, now would I?
Bro, this gossipverse is just... Dang. You're looking for Shuri made a success. Shuri is nice. Shuri will just still sell the stuff still, even though they are that mean, but still.
We really are just going to talk, right?
For sure.
Of course. I wouldn't do anything to one of my business partners, especially when a reasonable conversation should suffice.
Yeah, because last time we witnessed somebody got thrown out of the window. So this is close.
Who is it?
Venger, it's Chiori. We've worked together all these years. The least you could do is allow me a face-to-face conversation.
You also throw these years, you don't trust him?
Straightforward as always, I see. You know, there are certain conventions people usually follow if they want to seek someone's company. Sending a messenger, for example.
And when has following convention ever gotten me anywhere? Why hire a messenger when I can just explain things in person?
That's a great point.
Have you read the papers today?
I don't like to waste my time on baseless lies and speculation. Maybe that's something you should consider as well.
Ooh. Yep.
You're right. I only subscribe to the Steambird. And most days, I never even read the others.
It's from the Steambird?
So, these rumors. The Steambird was the one that published them?
Then we need to ask from Charlotte then.
No, not at all.
What?
They were in some second-rate fashion tabloids.
Well then, there you go. Those sort of headlines become old news faster than you can read them. Surely a bit of tabloid drama isn't worth cutting off my supply.
You would think that. But this time is different. Someone paid off the tabloids to publish the same article at once. They even went so far as to leave a copy in front of every house. That's how I first learned of the rumors.
Oh, so that's how everybody... Why do everybody read a random paper? What?
Every house? That means someone must have been planning this for a very long time.
Again, we already know who is it.
It seems your rival really pulled out all the stops this time, Shiori. The article was even published alongside a photo of you.
Ah. Wait, why didn't you at least help Shiori then? Why didn't you just pull it off?
What sort of photo?
Oh, I forgot. He probably don't want to get in trouble as well.
A photo of you beating up someone on the street yesterday.
Yeah, I kind of figured that's all the plan. So that what happened when Shiori pulled out somebody out. There's actually other people that take a picture.
Yesterday? Wait, that means...
Uchair again.
Here, I've got a copy. See for yourselves.
Okay, let's see. Show me. When I say show me, I didn't mean those. I mean the picture. Cherry Boutique darkness disguised behind a facade of fashion. Cherry Boutique located with our good court. Upon close investigation, many suppliers we discovered that there is something more to discover. Not only that, but many customers have also been subject to rough treatment at Shioria. Ah. A real brute that one never mind refusing to tailor my clothes. She literally tailored everything, bro. When we asked criminals why they appreciate this brand, the answer we received was that Shioria employed illegal competitive tactic to come on top, giving out evil and stuff like that. Wait! And people believe it even though they have become Shiori's customer? Again, Shiori is literally trying to fix everything. Like, I can, you know, redesign and restuff.
Behind the scenes, the true Chioria boutique takes shape. Not a fashion house, but a house of lies. Relying on its close ties to the criminal underworld, the Chioria brand employs illegal competitive tactics to come out on top, giving hope to the evildoers among us that wrongdoing can still prevail, provided you conceal it under the guise of fashion and beauty.
I don't know what happened, and I don't want to comment on things that I didn't see with my own eyes. Still, that photo shows you to be the clear aggressor.
Now, again, you need to know the full story, buddy. Also, you said that you don't want to believe what you don't see with your own eyes. You have worked with Shiori for years, and you pull back your stuff, really? But others harassed Shiori first, he even hired some goons to attack her career, literally.
Yeah, he was the one who started it, that little...
I appreciate you standing up for me, Paimon, but it can't be helped now.
That's right. The court of public opinion has already made up its mind. Still, I've got to give your rival high marks for effort. They even dug up the fact that my father once served time in the Fortress of Meripede.
Oh, they treat you, or... I see, that what happened.
But that was so long ago.
In the world of fashion, your past is like a piece of clothing stained with mud. Once tainted, it can never be washed clean.
What a word.
They claim that most of your clientele are criminals and that those who buy your clothes are just like you. People who silence all dissent with violence.
The absurdity. I don't even know which part to laugh at the most.
The fact that all of us are lies?
Well, it's no laughing matter.
It is.
Maybe your clientele are criminals. Maybe they're not. There's even the possibility that they're just people who happen to commit crimes after buying your clothes. But with the way this article combines fact with rumor, trying to determine the truth is practically an exercise of futility. It's not something people are just going to forget about in a day or two, especially when they've found several people to back up their claims.
Venger, are you sure you won't reconsider?
If we go through with the show together, we can defeat them fair and square.
Thanks, you're even try. Please, if you don't do that, I'm gonna hate you. Well, you're an NPC either way, so I don't care.
If I were younger, I might have said yes.
What? You're saying if you are dumb.
But I'm no longer that brave young man with nothing to lose.
Ah, I see.
I've got the family business to consider now.
Well, understandable.
I'd be perfectly happy to work with you again after this. But my daughter is manning the store during Fashion Week. And I don't want her implicated in all of this. She doesn't deserve to be swarmed by all that negative publicity.
Oh, it's just a parent that worried about their daughter. That's understandable. Still, Shuri's gonna be upset. Upset. Or something like, I don't know, just, you know.
I understand.
But yeah, understandable.
Let me offer you a piece of advice, Chiori. For old time's sake. Let this Fashion Week go. There's always next year. You just need to wait for all of this to blow over.
Nope, can do.
You're free to wait things out, Venger. I'll make my own choices.
Yep.
Have you ever thought maybe that attitude of yours is what's gotten you into all this trouble?
Probably, but at the same time, she has had on and on us, so it's not bad.
Have you ever thought maybe this attitude of mine is precisely what paved the way for my success?
Ooh, that's a great word there.
Well, fair enough. Then I suppose all there's left to say is best of luck. As for the models, none of them wanted to be implicated in all of this either.
Are you talking about me? Because I would love to.
Understood. Take care.
Oh, talking about the one that's on the Fashion Week. Well.
So, what should we do now?
Without the accessories, I can no longer use my old designs.
How could they do this? They're making things up. The boutique doesn't have anything to do with violent criminals. Can't people tell this is just a bunch of lies?
Public opinion has never been about what's true and what's not. It's about echoing the loudest voice in the room.
You know, sometimes the game is just a little bit too... Yeah.
I should have seen it from the beginning. Utair knows me too well. Everything that happened yesterday was just a trap.
I kind of already know that as well. I already say it. Or perhaps I just think it on my head, who knows.
Well... Guess all we can do is just head back for now.
Or... Charlotte! We need help. Oh, Charlotte's asking for truth.
Traveler! Paimon!
I'm guessing, yeah, because it's, you know, a spicy information.
Charlotte, what are you doing here?
Looking for you, of course. Did you see those fashion tabloids this morning?
You mean that sorry excuse for an article? Oh, just thinking about it makes Paimon's blood boil.
You too, huh?
Oh, yours a blood boil. Yeah, Charlotte wanted the truth as well, not just the lies.
Whoever wrote that article must have known the Steambird would never print something so defamatory. Unfortunately, not all papers in Fontaine share our same sense of journalistic integrity.
Ah, I see.
Miss Chiori doesn't deserve to suffer all this baseless slander. I was just about to find some people to interview so that I can write an article to refute all those claims. If there's one thing I can't stand, it's people who misrepresent and distort the facts.
Dang, I like Charlotte.
That's great! With your help, we might be able to get some people back on our side!
I'm more curious that why didn't we think about this in the first place? Or why didn't Paimon? Because I have been mentioning Charlotte.
It's my pleasure. I've met Miss Chiori several times. I know she's not the kind of person that article makes her out to be. She was the one who made the hat and tie for my camera, Monsieur Verite.
Interesting.
Speaking of Miss Chiori, do you know where she went? Alof told me you were all together.
Well, she's gone.
She was just here. Maybe she went over there? Let's go check.
I see, we didn't know she walked away. Dang, she's definitely mad about all of this as well. It's gonna be interesting if everybody has to talk about this. But imagine everybody right now, the conversation, the chat and everything just change. That'll be cool, but man. Again, this person understandable, don't want anything bad.
If you ask me, I think Chiori Boutique is done for. I mean, what did they expect? Engaging with criminals behind their customers' backs.
Yep, everything taken care of. But understandable, don't want anything bad happen to their daughters, but still, that's cruel. We're gonna get that conversation over here.
They kept up a solid front, though. I've even bought from them before.
Really? How was it?
It's good.
The owner was plenty fierce, that's for sure. Makes sense if she regularly deals with criminals, I guess. I've got the chills just thinking about it.
There was that as well. Alright, move on. Really? Rumor, I guess. Don't see Shiori.
Oh no, we've lost her. Did you hear what all those people were saying? Paimon can't believe they bought all that nonsense.
Well, again, people that have nonsense only buy nonsense.
Miss Chiori doesn't often appear in public or give a lot of interviews, so the general public hasn't had a chance to really get to know her.
I guess so, but at the same time, if you have already bought a cloth from her, yeah, you should already know that she's not that bad. It's just I know her mouth run a little bit something, but...
It's also true that her way of dealing with things can be a little...
Yeah.
...extreme sometimes.
Agree.
It's easy to use that to mislead people who don't know anything else about her.
This is all Utir's fault! Paimon would pick him up and throw him across the room too if she could!
You're too small to carry him. Just let me do it.
Wait a second. You don't think Chiori might have gone looking for him, do you? You know, so she can, finish what she started?
That's funny, isn't it?
That would only make the situation worse for her. I'm sure Miss Chiori knows that too.
You've got a point. Let's just return to the boutique and see if she's there then.
What could possibly have gone wrong? I have a feeling a lot of people are outside the boutique right now. So dang. I really hope we can ask Nervaletti's help as well.
Who's this?
Oh, the wedding dress! Oh, you're gonna show everything nice. Our savior.
This is Miss Letitia. She's also here to see Miss Chiori.
Not to return, I'm pretty sure, judging by her smile.
Oh, you were the one who came to collect the wedding dress yesterday, right? Wait, please don't say you're returning that dress too.
Oh, no, not at all. I'm just here to thank her. In fact, if there's anything I can do to help her out, I'd be more than willing.
Yeah, I know this person's gonna help us, that's for sure.
So you've come across that article as well.
Yeah, you probably don't know this. But after I got engaged, I didn't think I'd be able to wear a Chioria dress on my wedding day.
Big fan type of stuff, so yeah.
Why?
My fiancé owns a small business. It doesn't bring in a lot of mora, but we get by. After he proposed, he took me to Chioria Boutique, and we put down a custom order for a dress. He probably noticed how often I talked about Miss Chiori's clothes, and how pretty they were. Being able to wear one of her dresses to my wedding has always been my dream.
Interesting.
And then?
Then Chiori helped you?
And then, something happened to the business. And we ran into major mora problems. We were able to scrounge up enough to pay off our debts, but it left us without the funds to pay for the dress.
But didn't Chiori say she was able to make the dress from what was left of the original deposit?
Oh.
Yes. When I came to cancel the order, she asked if something happened, and I told her everything.
And she just gave you, I guess?
She heard me out, and then told me not to worry. She assured me that the deposit I paid would be enough for the dress. And that she'd be able to finish making it in time as well. She promised that I'd be able to wear a Chioria dress on my wedding day.
Dang, wait, Charlotte can also use this for the interview stuff. Or the headline, or... Not headline, what is it called? Yeah, like the quote?
Well, that's a good thing, isn't it? I've always known Miss Chiori to be a woman of her word.
It is good. It's just... After I went home yesterday, I couldn't help but take out the dress and try it on. My fiancé happened to walk into the room and when he saw me, he froze on the spot.
Didn't Chiori say it?
What a shame. He's not supposed to see it until the wedding day.
Yep.
Well, see, that wasn't actually the issue.
Is it about a Sharia tabloid style?
He's seen a lot of wedding dresses in his time doing business. So as soon as he saw it, he knew for sure that it must have cost far more than what we paid.
Oh, I see. So Sharia's like, yeah, this is enough to pay. But little did she know it's more fancier than you thought. Gotcha.
Huh? So wait, that means...
That means Shiori actually do that normally. Like, what is it called? Like, make it better? Even though, you know, yeah, the pay is not much.
Yeah. Miss Chihori covered all the costs and held nothing back.
Yep.
The fabric, accessories, beading, construction. It was all of the highest quality.
Oh, that's why you want to help her more. I thought it's only because she designed you the outfit alone. But no, not just design the dress, she also literally go all out.
Huh.
I guess because it's a special day, right? Wedding, so...
Miss Letitia, I'd really like to use your story for a piece I'm writing about the boutique. Would you mind going on the record?
Ha! Like I told you, Charlotte will use this.
Huh? Well, if it would help Miss Chihori out, I wouldn't mind at all.
Yeah, even though people are... If you are nice and kind and help other people, even though world turns upon you, there will some people try to back you up.
I think it'd go a long way. Your real experience is more powerful than all those lies combined.
Hey, Alof! Has Chihori come back here since we left?
Huh? I thought you were all together.
Uh-oh.
Well, we were. If she didn't come back here, then do you know of any other places she could have gone?
I don't want to know where, not gonna lie, but...
Oh, I remember now. There's this one cliff by the sea. Miss Chihori would always go there whenever she was upset.
Ah. Okay, at least... Okay, I thought she was gonna go to other house and, you know, burn the house down, but... That way.
In that case, why don't we split up? I'll continue interviewing Miss Letitia, and you two can go look for Miss Chihori.
Gotcha.
Alright, sounds good. Let's go!
Dang. Again, I guess luckily Letitia used the outfit, and, you know, the husband see it, so that way they know that's expensive. Yeah, no, definitely worth to help with.
Miss Chihori isn't the sort to just give up.
I know.
She probably just needs a place where she can think in peace.
Pull off the hat, yes. Always do it with, you know, cool head.
Did you read the paper today?
So, in your opinion, what is Miss Chihori like as a person?
Let's see. Well, she's certainly not afraid to say what she means, but she always looks out for her customers however she can.
Yeah, she helped me a lot. Dang. I don't know if Chihori is... Well, Chihori is probably a real... Or there's somebody that's like Chihori in our world, but... It's pretty rare. Okay, let's see. I don't want to hear her cry. I hope we don't hear her cry, but... She's just sitting on the cliff. That is so sad. Let's see. I'm here for you.
There you are, Chihori!
Uh-huh. How did you know where I... Alof told you, didn't she?
Is it about to pan out and show her crying?
She did. We were just looking for you at the shop, and Letitia was there. She wanted to thank you for the dress. So, you see? You don't have to be sad. We'll figure out how to get through this together.
I'm not upset. I just wanted to get some fresh air.
Yeah, I was about to pan out and show her cry, but I just pressed space because I didn't know I was gonna pan out like that.
Wanna sit here with me? The view's quite stunning.
It's pretty high up. It doesn't look like there's a lot of space. I'm a little bit scared. Unless I'm sitting somewhere else.
Sorry about that. I'm the only one here most of the time.
Gotcha.
Alright, don't mind if we do.
All of a sudden she holds our hand. Oh. What a view, actually.
Well, how does it feel?
This place is pretty great.
Right? It's quiet and open, and far from the relentless critique from fashion commentators and the media. It's just you and the beautiful scenery.
Yeah, it's important to take yourself out of that kind of stressful environment every once in a while.
I didn't grow up in a very strict family. My parents would joke that I grew up to be so assertive because they spoiled me as a child. I would get together with the other children to climb trees and explore caves. One time, I even climbed over the walls of the Kamisato estate. One of the servants had to physically remove me.
Whoa, Paimon would have never imagined that!
But even as rambunctious as I was, when it came to needlework, I was as quiet and focused as could be. It was as if I discovered a whole new world within those vibrant, dazzling fabrics. You know the feeling?
Sorta.
My parents noticed, and they sent me to study under a famous Inazuman tailor. It wasn't long before I had driven away pretty much every master tailor on the archipelago. You could say I really tried their patience.
You were that misbehaved?
I wasn't misbehaved, exactly. I just often had strange ideas when it came to fashion. Ones that weren't in line with traditional ways of doing things. On top of that, I hated the idea of groveling and making outfits for every arrogant big shot expecting me to be at their beck and call. Anyway, a few incidents later, I soon found myself without a master. Worse, not one shop was willing to hire me. Not even to do grunt work.
No wonder you left Inazuma.
I was angry and frustrated. So, before I left, I swore to all those masters that my brand would one day become renowned all over Teyvat.
Well, that's a great dream to strive towards.
After that, I came all the way to the Court of Fontaine, a city often referred to as the capital of arts and fashion. I had a lot of fun starting out. Sure, I was living in a small cramped room, but I was finally free to make whatever I wanted. I had a far more naive view of fashion back then. As long as something was pretty, it would become popular, right? A simple concept, surely. Of course, as I spent more and more time in the industry, I learned nothing was ever that simple. Least of all, fashion.
Well, I know someone who absolutely adored your design. And dream of wearing one at her wedding.
Oh, you mean Letitia? Yeah, she did mention that dream. I'll be honest with you. That's the first time I ever heard something like that from one of my customers.
Dang. Again, it seemed like you want to create outfit for Navia.
Who would have thought? Even as I continue to pursue my dream, my work has also become someone else's.
Yeah, that's nice.
All right, that's enough sightseeing for one day. Time to come up with a way out of this mess.
Ooh, looks like you've got your game face back!
Back? I was never gone to begin with. I did say I wasn't upset, didn't I?
Okay. Worrying for you is a little bit...
Paimon thinks we should look for evidence that Uter wrote that article, and that he hired those treasure hoarders to attack Kirara. Charlotte's already working on an article to address all those nasty rumors so we can publish all our findings in the Steambird once we're done.
So the public stuff is Charlotte taking care of.
I don't like duking it out in the press. But if Charlotte's thrown her hat in the ring, I won't stop her either.
Because nobody can.
I know where Uter's clothing factory is located. It might be a good place to start looking for some evidence.
Ooh. Wait, is it gonna be a sneaky mission then?
Sounds good! We'll come with! As for Fashion Week, well, there's always next year, right? So there's no need to be too upset.
We're still going, buddy.
Huh? When did this become an either-or situation? Find incriminating evidence or participate in Fashion Week. I'm doing both.
Aha! Multi-talented.
But your accessories! Didn't you say your designs were unusable without them?
I mean, that is all design, Paimon. Yeah, I kind of figured. It's like suddenly those, you can create a new one.
Well, it's true that I haven't quite figured out what to do about that, but to tell you the truth, even here in Fontaine, every time I see the sea, I can't help but remember Inazuma and the vow I made in front of those masters. Thinking about all that, I just can't bear to take even one step back. The sea.
Oh, getting an idea? We're just gonna use the pearls?
What did you just say, Chiori?
I see.
The sea. Seashells, coral.
Oh yeah, you don't need a good design. You can just use those. Yeah, from nature.
I've got it.
Got what?
Ocean.
Come, let's take a dip, shall we?
We'll get where we'll swim. We are apparently swimming.
Chiori, wait, hold up!
I wonder why Lumin always seems like she is about to scream, because she never say a thing. But it seems like we're taking a swim. Right, it's not bad. I do want to go back to where Charlotte is, but I wonder if anything changed.
Why did you just jump into the sea all of a sudden?
Paimon, what do you think is the most beautiful thing in the sea?
Shell.
Pearl. A Lumitwal? Or a pearl, maybe?
Ooh, ocean outfit will look nice.
Oh, Paimon gets it now! You want to use things like that as the accessories for your designs!
Well, now that you hit the nail on the head, help me grab some, would you?
Alright, by defeating this crab. Okay. Also, narrating is, luckily, I am not the one that's on the story. Why? Because now that you are swimming, you are the most beautiful thing in the water. Yeah, lucky I'm kinda not in the story, aren't I? I'll be start saying some word like that. Lovely Lumitwal. Nice. So I love if they give you a skill to actually do something to this enemy, but... Right from seafloor. I mean, I already got a lot as well. Okay, I guess I have to do something here. Yeah, wrong one, I need to get closer. Feral conch look weird though. I don't know.
These should be enough, right? Paimon picked all the prettiest ones in this area. Chiori, will these do?
This is the first time seeing Paimon actually swimming. Last time, well, we fish her out.
Everything looks great. I've also collected a pretty big batch, so we should have enough.
Just while there inside water, your voice is not supposed to echo like that, like you are inside a cave, but... Again, this is our second time hearing it. First time is Yoimi and Ayaka.
Great! So are we gonna head back now and make some new designs?
Yes, but don't forget. We've got more than just the designs to worry about when we get back.
Yeah... Because we are doing these two. Now I'm curious how she's gonna do this, actually. We return to the boutique with Chiori. From a lot of game, I've seen a lot of-
We've got the materials for the accessories. Next, we'll need to use what we have on hand to create some new outfits.
I've seen a lot of outfit, and I have seen on other game that's like coral outfit. So I'm looking for that, but who is gonna wear it?
You mean we have to start from scratch? Will there be enough time?
For Chiori, will be always enough time.
I should be able to make it, if I skip out on sleep.
That's not-
Oh no, skipping out on sleep is not the answer! Wait, how come this conversation is giving Paimon major deja vu?
Ka-ching! Ganyu! Sounds pretty similar to one we have had with Ganyu before. Yeah, Ganyu, how is the paper? It will be done if I just skip, you know, few sleeps. I guess going after you won mean making certain sacrifice.
Ganyu? Who's that?
It's... well...
A friend of ours who does way too much overtime. Well, anyway, sleep is important. You're not gonna convince Paimon otherwise.
You're not gonna convince me and Yuya as well.
Well, I can't argue with you there. One thing's for sure, though. I'm going to do whatever it takes to make it work. All this grit and determination. It reminds me of the first Fashion Week I ever participated in.
What else can we help with?
Let me see.
Models?
I suppose all there's left to do is tear up all the outfits currently on display.
You got it! Wait, what did you just say?
wait, what? I love her character like, yep, that's also smart. Right, wait, what?
You heard me. Tear them all up.
Yeah, I guess.
When I went to that first fashion week, I had no savings to speak of. Just a few dozen yards of fabric and a dream. I had to make something work, so I tore up all the clothes that I brought with me from Inazuma, and I used the scraps to make my entries for the show. I used the larger pieces for the base fabric,
and the smaller pieces for accessories.
Oh, I see. That's... gotcha. So, destroy like a big chunk and create a new one and look prettier. Or a lot of chunk and make it into a big one.
If it worked back then, why not now? We can also repurpose some of the ready-to-use accessories in the shop as well.
Dang, big brain.
But you worked so hard on all these outfits.
Well, it's no use at this point, so might as well, right? Yeah, that's a good point.
I know. That's why I refuse to let it all go to waste. I'm not going to let them win. Even if it takes everything I've ever made and more.
Okay, then... here goes nothing.
Worst case scenario, I can help her because I got 40 million mora.
No need to be nervous. I won't hold it against you. Of course, if anyone dared to tear up one of my dresses in front of me on a normal day, I'd probably toss them into the sewer.
Or out of the window, but... you are the one that ordered me, so... it's kind of
just nightmare. This once, though. I think I can make an exception. Go ahead and tear them up. Think of it as a good way to vent your emotions.
If only they let me to use other character. I really hope I can use... can I? Oh, I can. Oh, I can. Cool. I mean, where's Shiori? Alrighty. It doesn't work. Never mind. I'm about to use Shiori's ult, but it's fine. Oh, interesting. I don't think Meg outfit wet will turn into like that, but cool.
Good job. That should do it.
And that's easier because I got ult.
Chiori, are you alright? Sorry for taking so long. I got caught up and... whoa. What happened to your shop?
Oh, there you go. I was wondering what happened to Navia, because Navia's gonna be super worried, but... Navia got caught up.
Who did this? Those monsters. Slandering you in the papers wasn't enough for them, was it? They even sent people to wreck your shop.
I don't think that can actually happen. But it's alright, Navia. Calm down. Yeah, Navia's also, again, like Shiori, friend is super important.
Give me their names. Since they're all too eager to tear up other people's clothes, I think it's about time the Spina di Rosula return the favor.
Do not give name. Whatever you do, Shiori, do not give name.
Maybe you should calm down a bit first, because you see...
I was the one who did it. Please go easy on me.
Ugh, what is this, a soap opera? I was the one who asked the traveler to tear up the outfits. We need all the fabric and accessories we can get.
Oh, so that's what happened. I guess I got a bit ahead of myself just now. Back to what you were doing, everyone. You can all just pretend like I didn't say anything.
It's kind of scary for me part, because not gonna lie. Yeah, without concept or what? Without, you know, the team, we don't know what's going on.
Navia sure is scary when she's angry.
Yeah, the eyes? I am scared.
If there's one thing I can't stand, it's a false accusation.
Yeah.
No one's gonna orchestrate some conspiracy to take down one of my friends and get away with it.
Again, for people that didn't know, it's gonna be a spoiler, so just skip like 20 seconds or 30 seconds, I guess. But yeah, Navia's father got accused of a false accusation, so that's why she's very, very mad.
You and Chiori are really close.
If you already skip, yeah, this is the part.
Of course. Everyone knows that Chiori makes the most gorgeous outfits in town. All of the Spina di Rosula's formal wear is custom-tailored here.
Now, if only you'd give me the contract for your uniforms as well.
As if you'd enjoy designing something as boring and formulaic as a uniform. That's why I didn't ask you in the first place, silly. Plus, with how much your intel has helped us out in the past, to the Spina, you're more of an intelligence agency than a fashion boutique.
If I had it my way, it would be the other way around.
Anyway, we both know why I'm here. Tell me, how can the Spina be of service to you?
After remembering Navia using the sunglasses and walked just casually with Kirara, I couldn't help but to think she's a little bit... whatchamacall, like fun to be with?
If it's not too much trouble, Can I borrow some skilled hands to help with some simple sewing work?
Oh yeah, that as well.
I'll need all the help I can get if I'm going to finish these outfits over the next few days.
Also, Navia is good at that. I mean, good at Macron, she'll be good at this, right? Oh right, Silly. I couldn't help but to see Navia Silly. Other than the part when she's become mad.
Oh, no problem. I've got a few of those guys all ready to go. I just knew you wouldn't be intimidated into withdrawing from this year's show. When are you going to get started? I can help with sewing too.
Actually, there's something else I'd like to ask of you.
Wait, it's not gonna be Lumine's the one that wear the outfit.
Ask away. I'm all ears.
Oh, and Traveler and Paimon, could you help me pass word to Linny and Lynette? I'll need their help as well.
Gladly. Even the house. Or is it for the outfit? I'm guessing it's the outfit.
I'm done with my interview! Has Miss Chiori made it back yet? Go! Oh! What happened to the boutique?
Don't say something about the name.
Who did this? Give me names! No. I'll make sure every last one lands a full feature on the front page of the Steambird tomorrow!
Guys, please calm down. Deja vu.
Not this again.
Oh, that's hilarious. I love that.
What should we do about these clothes everywhere? Need any help?
Sort them by the type of fabric first, and then by color. Oh, and don't forget to remove any accessories and put them to the side.
That sounds pretty straightforward. I'll help too.
I love the giving name part and then like, not this again. Gosh darn it, all the character I got is pretty much this character over here. Man, everybody, friend, help, heartwarming. I love it. Okay, where do we go, Linny and Lynette, right? Even the heart. I don't know if Arleshino's gonna help, aka the father. Still don't get why is it the father. But Linny and Lynette for sure is gonna help. Again, I'm pretty sure Linny and Lynette's the one that... Or no, I'm pretty sure the one that designed their outfit is Shiori. Designed the Linny and Lynette outfit. Hey, show.
Linny, Lynette! Great, you're both here!
I'm guessing you guys know what is going on.
A moment later and you'd have missed us.
We read the article in the papers. We were just about to go find Miss Chiori.
I knew it.
She helped design a number of our costumes in the past and even sponsored one of our performances. The time has come, it seems, for us to return the favor.
I mean, if we miss you guys, it's also fine, because, you know, in the end, you are going to Shiori is.
Oh, perfect! She was the one who sent us!
Also, I feel like that person just messed with the wrong person. Messed with Shiori, and Shiori got all of these fish and holder backing up. Bro, that person is dead.
In that case, I assume that there's something we can do to help. Just say the word and we'll take care of it.
I know how both of them already know we're gonna, you know, it's something about Shiori.
Okay, so it's like this.
Yeah, so that happened. Yep.
Is that all we'll need to do?
Yep.
Should be a piece of cake for the two of us.
Paimon's glad to hear it!
Is it being modeled or what?
Well then, guess it's about time we go and find some evidence for all the bad stuff Utera's been doing, right? Chiori said we shouldn't disturb her over the next couple of days. We can check in with her again once she's done with all the new designs.
But the show's in another 2 days, isn't it? Will she be able to make the deadline?
Wait, is Linny and Lynette gonna help us with evidence or no? I don't think so.
Well, according to her, she wants to first beat Utera fair and square at the show, and then defeat him in the court of public opinion. She said that it'd be like,
a two-pronged approach?
What does that mean?
Courtesy first, confrontation second.
Yeah, something like that.
Understood. Then we'll have faith in her decision. We'll go make some preparations. See you at the venue in 2 days.
All right, we're counting on you!
Yeah, it feels so nice when everybody is trying to help. Man, it feels so good.
Then let's also do as Chiori said, and meet up with her at Utera's factory in 2 days. We'll gather the evidence then.
Oh, okay, I was about to ask, are we gonna get trial? Because it doesn't seem like Chiori's gonna play part on the beating up stuff, but no.
Oh, Paimon sure hopes she won't have a hard time making all those new outfits for the show.
Well, I don't think she will, but not sleeping is quite bad. Yeah, don't look at me though. Surprisingly, I can actually re-enter here before we skip down. Never mind. Shiori said that needs all the time to make clothes for the fashion show. Best not to disturb her for now. But there's no point going back. Alright, skipping time. They've been skipped. So we should be good,
boring.
Right?
Boring! Isn't there anything else more
we just
interesting
go
to do?
Wait, so... Alright, Free, now skipping time is not important. We cannot skip... Or not skip. We cannot hear. So I'm guessing we just meet up. That is the factory underground? Really? That seems... lame. Also, because of this, we have to switch out party. I guess it's gonna let us switch to other party in the end, but... Where do I put my Navia party? Oh wait, if Shiori's on number 5, will it switch to my number 1 party?
Oh, you're here.
I'm here! No, I'm Rick.
Shiori! How are the new outfits coming along? You look kinda tired.
Can I see the face?
Just a few steps left now.
She seems fine.
I've handed the rest over to Alof. We should be able to make tonight's show.
Wow, that's cutting it real close. Are you sure she'll be okay without you?
Don't worry. I have no intention of giving ground on either front. With the fashion show scheduled for tonight, Uther has closed his factory. This is our only chance to secure any incriminating evidence.
Oh.
Okay, Paimon totally gets that this is all his fault and he totally deserves it, but... wouldn't we technically be trespassing on his property if we just barge in like this?
His factory is usually open to the public. It may not be open for business right now, but that doesn't mean visitors can't stop by for a tour.
Ooh, that's his fault.
We're just curious customers after all, aren't we?
Big brain.
Well, when you put it that way...
Alright, Paimon, stop concerning about this stuff. We need to concern about our friend more.
Anyway, Uther's factory is right over there. Let's hurry up and get moving.
Oh, it's that one?
Why would he open a factory over there?
Yeah, what?
We have different marketing strategies. While I specialize in high-end custom garments, he prefers low prices and large sales volumes. I don't know. Maybe the rent here is cheap.
All right. Ooh, it's really creepy. Paimon would never choose to buy anything from a place like that.
Also, didn't Navia like live or not live? More like this is Pina East, was it?
You make a good point. Let's all be on our guard.
Yeah, wait, isn't that the case? Or is it not? Wait, did I remember wrong? Also, I should have still used Shiori, gosh darn it. That way I can just TP up here. Well, rather than TP, it's more like catching skill, but still. Okay, need a Geo character, easy. Again, don't need to bring Shiori if you don't have Shiori, because the game will also give you Shiori. Oh, I should have bring somebody can do Geo construct. Ah, well, I kind of forgot about that. And the battle gonna be loud. Let's see. There you go. Should be the BIS weapon, was it? Yep. Best in slot. Then we also got Noblesse Oblige for a... Yep, and also C3. So was it crit? It's crit build. It's got... Supposedly she is the damage dealer. Alright, I don't wanna miss a chest as well. This is kinda the annoying part about this place. My middle mouse button does not work. Gosh darn it. Like my middle mouse button broke. Yeah, this kind of annoying part about Genshin, you have to actually open your eyes. What? That little small house that lives in a sewer? Open up to this? What? Crazy.
We're in. There really is nobody here.
Why is it so big and why is it like this, bruh? I feel like there's actually something in the middle though. Why am I sitting down? What am I doing? I kinda wanna explore around to see whether there's a chest, but I hope it's a straight.
Welcome, dear visitors.
Oh, Paimon nearly fell out of the air! What is that thing?
A mechanical guide. They usually use a recorded tape to give you a tour of the factory.
Please, follow me, dear guests.
That's normal? Wait, am I supposed to... Well, I'm supposed to follow it, but... Am I supposed to explore around alone? I'm guessing we're gonna come here in the end, but... I can die? Am I supposed to follow it? I feel like I should follow it first. Wait, I'm on my own exploration. Oh, you cannot go in there. Ah... That's the going out part. Gotcha, alright, let's meet with the robot. Okay, so that is interesting. I still don't wanna miss any chests, so that's why I'm still running. I can go up here? I'm gonna run around. Alright, robot looking thing, I have to make sure that there's no chest. Let's go. You go first and say something about that. Yeah. Can I go there? Nope. Ignore me, don't mind me. Let's keep going.
First stop on our tour is a look at the gradual evolution of our clothing brand.
I see. All kinda new. Ah. That look like... Okay. Interesting.
Second. After that, we welcome you to peruse our most popular styles.
Huh. Otera seems to be doing pretty well for himself, doesn't he? Why would he feel the need to bother you when he could just focus on improving his own brand?
We will learn, I guess.
This is the studio where our designs are made. Please, take a look around at your leisure.
Yep, this seems like Uter's workspace, all right. Let's see what we can find.
Let's see what we can find. Yeah, probably there's some bad story that happened in the past, or maybe outfit bad stuff happened. Alright, let's keep going. Oh, this place. Still making sure I did not miss any chairs. Excuse me, robot, cannot talk to you. Marketing, 100,000 mora. Puny, I got 14 million. The next one, we're here. The courier shall arrive at the city in the morning. The courier of what? The example of Uther's old design, there's nothing strange about them yet.
These are the fitting rooms. Please use them at your leisure.
Huh? Wait, what? There seems to be something in this fitting room.
A mirror. Maybe something behind the mirror. Also, another thing that I noticed is that maybe all of the newspaper stuff is actually the doing of him. Yeah, he have done all of those stuff. That face. He done the, you know, the brand with bad people. Maybe? I don't know. Oh, it's closed.
Why did the door
elevator?
Hold on tight, Paimon.
Why is it moving?
Well, why is it moving? Because it's an elevator. Oh, well, it's fitting. The music changed. What happened? Can I at least sit down?
It seems to have stopped.
What in the earthquake? It feels like an earthquake. Ah.
Where did this thing take us?
It seems like we're someplace deeper inside the factory.
Yeah, I'm guessing all of the bad thing that talk about is actually about them. It's not made up, it's about them, but made so sure is the one. Okay, I'm making sure I didn't miss any chests, but I don't think I can make sure that I don't miss any. We're swimming now in the sewer. Ew. I cannot dive. I really hope bringing... Oh, I did have free now. What am I talking about? Can I climb up? I cannot climb up. No, I should have used free nice skill first. Gosh darn it. Wait, can I go up somewhere? What is this? Well, that's kind of annoying. I did have a free now, but I didn't know I'm gonna fall down like that. Nor do I know that you cannot actually climb anywhere. Yeah, won't this be easy? Gosh darn it.
Look out, chess. There are guards here.
Oh no, whatever shall I do? What, just use this?
Coming at ya. Hey there.
That is actually fast. Man, those cool attacks I still love. Easy. Shuri. Oh, I forgot when you are inside here, they don't say anything. Can I? Cannot. Alright. I don't think there's no longer any secret chests, because so far the story in Genshin, I feel like they never put a random chest anymore. If you put a hole, I'll jump in game, so don't put a hole. Obviously I like to jump in a hole. Ah. What do I say? That actually seems good. Can I go here? I can't go there. Yeah, why will I follow that deadly path?
This place is filthy!
entire shop seriously made here?
I guess.
Look over there.
That's why it's in quantity? Oh no.
Ooh, that water looks super nasty. Oh, Paimon can smell the stench from all the way over here.
And I was the one using unsafe materials, Uther.
So he was actually the one who opened an underground factory.
Yeah, it's not base. It's like the story of everything. It just changed the person. That's why it's easier to me.
No wonder his clothes always felt weird to the touch. He's been using all manner of tricks here in a bid to cut costs.
Should the clothes made here even be worn?
Never mind issues with shrinking and fading. These materials can give you skin problems if you wear them too often.
That's terrifying! Let's take some photos right away as evidence.
At least I don't know how the camera go there, we don't have drone, but at least it works.
This way he won't be able to try and deny anything in court. Alright, let's keep going.
Now, question. How did people... Yeah, if you go to the feeding room, why did the elevator move? If it's like a tour for other people, right? And I don't get that part of the story. Yeah, I know. I love... Okay, so this story is actually showing how to use Shiori. Interesting. Huh?
Doesn't look like there's a path here.
Follow me. Let's go up.
Follow you? I don't think Lumin can do this, but... Okay. Whee! Oh, you're actually slowly going down. Or descending. Cool. That is actually interesting. The other story, they never show how character is used. Like for example, for Alhatum, I'm pretty sure they never show something like this. Niluan is only open world, finding a tiger. Just kind of annoying. Not gonna lie. I hope there's more. Ooh, there's something there. Am I supposed to go there yet? I feel like I should probably not, but... I'm waiting for the cooldown, don't mind me. What is here? Guess that's for later. Alright, let's stop messing around. Damn, Shiori! Again, like you said, it's not safe. Don't just take a dive. Okay, let me see if there's anything around here. There's nothing. Alright, let's keep going! Anything here?
This place seems like some kind of warehouse! Ugh, and it stinks too!
Wait, what? What is this? Oh, it's just bleh.
What's going on? Our way in's been blocked!
He wants to trap us in the factory. Oh, so she know we're gonna come. Gotcha.
Seems like he knew we'd be coming.
I say that.
You did say he knew you really well, didn't you?
Also, another thing is, yeah, that blue thing is the camera, I guess.
Yes. And that's because we used to be partners.
Ah, I see how everything can go wrong now.
But you're practically at each other's throats! Now you're telling us you used to work together?
When I first came to Fontaine, we were both fledgling designers who longed to gain a foothold in the world of fashion. We shared the same goal, so we decided to work together. In the beginning, we both wanted to make clothes that would stand out from the crowd and shatter tradition. The kind of clothes that would turn heads and leave people in awe. But with every criticism we received, and every sponsor that rejected us, Uther's confidence disappeared little by little.
Ah, I see.
Finally, right before Fashion Week, he came to the conclusion that we wouldn't be able to make the designs we always dreamed of, and we parted ways. For my part, I gambled it all and devoted everything I had to that 1 week. I came out the other side with something that really made me proud. I was nervous to present it, of course, but I knew it was my chance to show the industry what I was made of. In the end, well...
You received the acclaim of all Fontaine while Uther gave up on his dream and turned to making this sketchy stuff.
Well, sketchy and dodgy, it's die anyway. Interesting. So now he hate you because... Gotcha.
I don't know the exact details of what happened after that. All I know is, after I opened Chiori Boutique, he's harassed me every year since.
He's just jealous of what you've accomplished. A guy like that doesn't deserve your sympathy.
I mean, we don't know the full story, but who knows? Obviously, people are gonna go with jealous, but...
Well, let's focus on getting out of here first.
I just break the wall easy.
Missing the show is as good as letting him win.
I mean, I got Navya with a...
There are some control panels over there. Let's see if any of those buttons do anything.
Well, I never see any cloth factory, you know, using bad stuff, but that's... And this story become a little bit more interesting. Okay, what do these do?
Oh, that doesn't seem to have done anything. Maybe try the next one?
Okay. Do I have to go up?
That didn't do anything either.
Let me try the next one? I thought it's self-destruct. It seems like it is self-destruct. Also, too much button to press. I have no idea what to press at this point.
Look over there. Seems like there's a way out. Maybe we can use these mechanisms to get higher.
Too much? I used too much ult.
Unauthorized intruders entering expulsion mode.
Explosion mode. Self-destruct. Why? Why are you self-destructing? I know we are supposed to time that, but man, if I bring Kuching, this can be faster.
Unauthorized intruders.
Okay, that's cool. New mechanism. Well, it's kind of old mechanism. Yeah, again, that's camera. I guess they are somebody are seeing us. Yeah, like Shiori is going up. Where am I going? Oh, that dude.
Unauthorized intruders entering expulsion mode.
Yeah. Shiori can go kaboom. I can also even pay less. Care about it. Okay, a little chest is straightforward, so it's easier. I love how they are not, you know, commentating about to explode.
We finally made it out. Why does it feel like the movement patterns of those mechs have changed?
Warning. Unauthorized intruders. Initiating shutdown procedure.
Yeah, are we not gonna talk about the explosion thingy? Oh, okay. What the heck?
Warning. Unauthorized intruders. Initiating.
I should have gave up. Yeah, I should have gave up following that thing over there.
Whee!
I need to wait for my cooldown, or yeah, I'm not gonna make that. Ah! I made it worse. Alright.
Warning.
Just be fast and you're gonna be A-okay.
Initiating shutdown procedure.
I don't know where did it just aim me, but oh. Okay, that worked, I guess. It just point my... I'm trying to aim there and then it aim my aim here, so... Ooh, chess! Three chess! Big chess. Alright, very big. I need to go down there. Oh, this is how we get out from the previous gacha. The one I randomly explored. Cool. Wait, Tail and Spiky are swimming in a sewer then. Oh. Now... Unless there are a lot of pretty flower. Also, Shiori, yeah, because of the bubble, it's kind of, anyway. Okay, let's see.
We're finally out of that stinky place. Let's take this evidence and get out of here.
Guessing somebody's gonna stop us right about now.
Finally, the entrance at last.
Now, how about the robot, the egg robot? Yep.
Oh, those chambers couldn't hold you, I see. What a surprise.
Do you know why I have fight a dragon? Probably not. Alright, anyway.
We've collected a bunch of evidence on all the nasty stuff happening at your factory. You're not getting away this time, Uther.
I'm guessing you're gonna say if you can get out of here alive.
The evidence on your person, you mean? What makes you think I have any intention of letting it get past these walls?
What make you believe that you cannot hold me back? I fight a dragon. This is puny for me.
More mechanical guards? Really?
Ever thought about using these funds for a legitimate purpose?
Oh, but this is a legitimate purpose.
What? Destroying Chioria Boutique? Or continuing to make your rotten rags?
Proving that fashion is merely a laughable farce, a carnival of ignorance.
Gotcha, so it's not just jealousy. Another thing is that hatred.
You know what your problem is, Uther? You've become so obsessed with the concept of fashion itself that you let it paralyze you. Stop trying to cater to it. Focus on your own work, and you get to decide what fashion means.
Spare me the lecture, why don't you? Sooner or later, you'll cater to all the voices too, you know. After all, what is fashion but another form of public opinion?
Fashion is about aspiring towards a certain ideal. But it's up to you to decide what it is. My brand caters to no one but myself and my vision. That's my ideal, and it's not going to change.
Well, once the people witness their former darling's spectacular fall, they'll understand how laughable that ideal truly is.
I'm more surprised you are brave enough to walk between us right now. Because not gonna lie, I'm gonna beat you up immediately.
That's what you've been trying to prove all this time? Your jaded understanding of the industry is the reason you've had it out for my brand for so long? You weren't like this before, Uther. What happened to the man who wanted to make something that would bring the entire world to its knees?
He realized long ago how utterly naive and ridiculous that dream was.
Oh, utterly naive, I see.
You gave up on your dream. But that wasn't enough, was it? You had to find a way to prove to yourself that it could never have been possible at all. You think you understand. But you're just a bitter man who let his regrets dictate his choices. You regret giving up on your dream. So you stopped at nothing to prove to yourself that it wasn't the wrong choice. This whole thing, Uther. It's pathetic.
Pathetic? Why don't you take a look in the mirror? You're a fool daydreaming about taking all of Teyvat by storm. Well, good luck doing that when even Fontaine doesn't have a place for you anymore.
I'm more not understanding why you're not helping her instead, but sure, whatever.
You're right. Maybe all those who pursue their dreams are fools.
Ouch, did you just call me fools?
But more pitiful still are cowards who are too afraid to even attempt what the fool is brave enough to try.
Ooh, actually that's a good word.
You!
Whoa. Sherry, you go first. You've got a show to catch.
Yeah, just leave this guy to us.
We're pulling gun now? No longer a sword and, you know.
No, you go instead.
Wait, what?
It'll be fine. Just go to the venue and tell everyone to proceed with the plan.
Also, how are we gonna get out with all of these Gardamax?
I'll deal with him. Some lessons are best delivered in person.
I'm more scared to somebody than not scared to a gun. Alright, stay safe. Alright, let's go, Pam.
Catch up with us soon!
Trying to leave, are we?
Bro, your gun is not gonna do a thing.
I've held back all this time because of our past partnership, Uther.
Dang, that is cool.
But all that changed after our tour of your factory.
Still trying to talk tough, I see.
No matter what you've been through, no matter why you've become like this.
Oh, we actually already got out.
If I may borrow the words of a friend, a guy like you doesn't deserve my sympathy. Allow me to show you the true meaning of the Chioria brand.
You think? Everything?
The Chioria brand represents more than a person or a trademark. It's a way of life.
Greetings, friends at Fontaine Fashion Week. Please feast your eyes on the extravaganza that Chioria Boutique has prepared for you today.
Brilliant, dazzling, and wholly unique.
And most importantly,
an enduring, never-say-die spirit. That's the true meaning of the Chioria brand. And now, let's welcome the thundering seamstress, Miss Chiori herself!
Did Chiori not...
Let the show begin.
The world may change, fashion along with it, but Chioria will remain the same. No challenge is too great. Chioria caters to no one, not even the times. Rather, Chioria will always lead the fashion of our time. Finally, let's not forget. Only those who do not give up on their dreams are worthy of this brand. Well then, I suppose all that's left to say is, Happy Fashion Week, fellow dreamers.
What in the ads did I just show the stream? Why are we having an ads in the middle of those? Dang, those are cool though, Lynette Lini's outfit. I really hope it didn't show on that style, but it's not bad. I really hope it showed a different style, but that is so cool. Oh, I love that a lot.
How about this?
I really hope their outfit also, you know, you can, you know, change it. Or at least look like something else, but... Man.
A little more to the left.
Like this?
Perfect.
Also... She is already here. Kirara is already here again.
Phew.
I guess take like 3-4 days.
Oh, that looks great! Miss Chiori, can I take a picture?
Oh, for the headline, I think.
Of course.
I didn't know you'd make a brand new signboard.
I made it before Fashion Week. I figured it'd be best to put it up after the success of the show.
Well, how can you become renowned through all of Teyvat without a fancy signboard of your own? The Spina's way ahead of you in that regard.
Now that you mention it, perhaps our magic troupe could use one of those.
Our signatures are the Grinmalkin Cat and the Boggle Cat box. Oh, and we need to add Pear as well.
Oh yeah, that way the third person is not missed, aka Fremini.
Pear would need an alias, of course. How about... the Hangry Bird.
I see why they don't use angry. Also, another thing is, does that mean hungry and also mad at the same time? What a joke. What a joke.
So, does that mean your signboard is going to be two cats and a penguin stuffed into a single hat?
That will look cute.
Ooh, that sounds super snuggly and warm.
Agree.
And a bit cramped.
I forgot the net.
Miss Chiori, I'm done taking pictures. You can expect the article in tomorrow's Steambird, along with the evidence the Traveler gathered.
Thank you, Charlotte.
It's my pleasure. Bringing the truth to light is a journalist's duty.
Going forward, feel free to custom order any accessories you need for Monsieur Verite. It's on the house.
Huh? You really mean it?
Of course. The same goes for you too, Linny and Lynette. If you have need of any costumes in the future, just drop me a note.
What about something other than a costume?
Thank you, Chiori. It's much appreciated.
Lynette wanna eat some... some cake, some sweet stuff. Lydia's like, no. That's enough. If we let Lynette go more, it's gonna be dangerous.
Well, I don't really need anything. Just don't be a stranger, alright?
I don't need anything either. So long as you continue to request my international courier services from Comania Express, we're golden.
And then Chiori's gonna say, I didn't say I'm gonna let you guys, you know, have some free stuff.
Actually, that reminds me. When will you be leaving, Kirara?
The escorting.
Huh?
About that.
What happened?
The Spina di Rosula has prepared a special vehicle for you, so you can just get in and we'll push it all the way out of Fontaine.
I knew it. That's why Kirara don't wanna I see. Well then.
What? No, that's so embarrassing.
Ooh, do we get something nice too, Chiori?
Where does translate like glad you have toned it down? This time got a vehicle that is not toned down at all.
Of course. Just hold on a second. Disrupting public order at the show. Appropriating venue lighting equipment without authorization. Using weaponry in public. Hosting a dangerous performance without notifying the authorities.
Shivers, we can explain!
If you come across anyone who matches those descriptions, please report them to the Special Patrol at your earliest convenience.
We cannot explain then. We have no idea who that is. I see. So, forgot that.
Enjoyed that, didn't you? You nearly scared me half to death.
Chevra's definitely love to do that.
Says the one who pulled that stunt earlier. How about you do me a favor and tell me in advance next time you're planning something like that?
Well...
And if I had, would you have approved?
Nope.
No, but it would have at least spared me a whole lot of anxiety.
Well, I would say I more than made it up to you, have I not? A whole underground workshop in the Flue of Sandra, and the man responsible all tied up and handed to you on a silver platter. Sounds pretty thoughtful if you ask me.
All right, I won't argue with you. You can have this one.
Well, friends, I would say we've earned ourselves a nice meal for our efforts. Let's go. Spina's treat.
I'll have to take a rain check. I've still got a lot of paperwork to take care of, so you all go have fun. Oh, by the way, Chiori, I ran into Vanger on the way here. He had a message for you.
I don't need to hear it. I'm sure the old fool used pretty much every apology in the book. I'll just visit him some other day and give him a hard time about everything.
You know him well.
Yeah, I mean, it is what it is. Again, understandable, you don't want your daughter to, you know, get in trouble, or your kids, or your stuff like that, so...
Thanks again, Shelfrus.
My pleasure. Oh, and one last thing. That was really quite an amazing show.
It is. I am surprised. It's like a... It's literally a gnats, actually. It feels like a gnats.
You don't say.
You don't say.
All right. Follow me if you want in on the celebration feast. Come on, we're leaving.
Is it gonna end? Don't tell me it's gonna end.
Traveler, Paimon, could you go wait for me at that place with the view? I'll let Navia know that we'll be a little late. There's something I'd like to give you.
Oh?
A place with the view? Oh, Paimon knows where you mean. Sure, no problem.
Perfect. I'll be right there.
Proposing time. I kind of already figured what about to happen, but okay. I should probably try to find Navia first. Before we go to the place. Okay, let's meet her right over here then.
Yeah.
This is pretty much where
Forward.
She wants us to meet.
Scatter.
Right, let's see.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Also, I did run around, I didn't find Navia, but I didn't run that long.
Oh, we didn't wait long at all. But what did you want to give us that you couldn't share right in front of everyone else?
Here, take this.
Oh, wow! A brooch! And in the style of Chiria Boutique, too! Wait, Paimon gets one as well?
I only made two for now. After much consideration, I decided to give them to you two.
Ah, thank you. I'll take good care of it. Is it supposedly for Uther and... Probably, yeah. But it doesn't suit Lumi, not gonna lie, but at the same time, I don't know how brooch are where, so...
You've been a great help. Even when things were looking bleak, you stayed by my side. There were even times when I felt like I had to fight back and win. Even if it was just to honor the trust that you had in me.
A little, but Paimon would say you deserve most of the credit. This result, it was all you, Chiori.
I hope we can use that brooch forever. What?
I know for certain that was not the case. I've chased my dream for so long that I've come to understand something. Apart from conviction and persistence, the thing that matters most is having friends who believe in you even when you don't believe in yourself.
Yeah, so careful and pick your friend. And make sure you pick the right one.
A single person can only do so much. Without all your help, Chioria Boutique could have easily fallen to ruin.
Well, Paimon doesn't think it would have ever gotten to that point. Not if you had anything to say about it. But, about the stuff you said at the show, you aren't worried it'll rub some people the wrong way?
Also, another thing is, I mean, it's actually, you don't need to care. They don't even care about Chioria Boutique in the first place. But another thing is, even without us, I don't think anything can go wrong there, can it?
Perhaps my words were a little pretentious, but they do reflect how I truly feel. I won't bow or scrape before any force in this world, much less any individual. I'm confident in the quality of my work. Create something beautiful, and there will always be people who appreciate it.
Well, guess there's nothing to worry about then.
Create something, and there will always be people that appreciate it.
Should we go back and join them at the Victory Feast?
Oh, yes. Of course. But before that, I'd like to admire the view for just a little while longer. You know, of all the nights I've spent in Fontaine, I'd say this is the loveliest by far.
Hold her hand. But with that being said, the story when they talk about tonight is done. I kind of want to go to the Victory Feast, but man... Also, I don't think Lumine will be wearing the gift. Woven Dream, handmade brooch. But I don't think Lumine will be using that. I really hope Lumine do. Where is Lumine? Well, who knows? Either way though, with that being said, as always, thanks so much for watching. There you go. That Chioria is... Chioria? Chiori is the request. I enjoyed that a lot. Chioria chapter. I don't know how to read that. But yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed that. Subscribe, like button. Follow me on... Twitch as well, or link description down below for my socials, and I'll see all of you on the next video. Have a nice day or nice night. Thank you guys so much.